Siamo qui con Leslie Moore, editore di Road Racing Ireland, il magazine, come dicono loro, più lungo al mondo che copre le road races dal 1986. So, hello Leslie,
hello.
Can you please introduce yourself? I say it in Italian. You are the editor of Road Racing Ireland, the longest running magazine about pure road racing from 1986.
Yes, it's been going since May 1986. We've started up because Ireland is abound with road racing, but we weren't getting any coverage. There was no television coverage back in them days, so we started a magazine. We never envisaged it would go 28 years. You know, it's been a wonderful trail of success.
Yeah, so it's about from 1986. I mean, you have plenty of story to tell.
Oh, there's been plenty of stories. Unfortunately, there's some sad stories over the years. There's been many sad stories, but we've had some great success. We've enjoyed the Joey Dunlop World Championship days through to Philip McCallan and Robert Dunlop, and seeing the new younger Dunlops, William and Michael. You know, it's been a wonderful time.
Yeah, you cover all races throughout these 28 years of Road Racing Ireland, didn't you?
We've done every road race. We've been continuously going to the TT, the Manx, the Scarborough. We haven't been to Europe too much because it's just the work schedule, but we've got journalists like yourselves. You'll send in reports from Italy, you know, and we follow the Italian racing.
Yeah.
We have a lot of Italian subscribers, and we always meet them at the Ulster Grand Prix, and they love the magazine.
Yes. And which race do you cover with most passion? I mean, which is the race that you feel as a home race, something you feel pretty special?
The Ulster Grand Prix, the circuit-wise, is very, very, very special.
Right.
Because the World Championships back from Agostini, all the Jubilali, all the Italians have raced here when it was a World Championship. So it's the same corners, and you enjoy watching, you know, today's riders on the same circuit.
Yes. And the best memories you have as an editor, first of all, as a road racing fan.
As a road racing fan, I grew up with the Tom Hearn, and who raced with Agostini and all, in the Italian Championship or Grand Prix, and followed them through. But my most memorable occasions, whenever Joey Dunlop won the 2000 Formula One race.
Yeah,
that was very special.
Mega. Yeah, and what about today? Who are the new guns of road racing? I mean, both Dunlops, obviously. Who else?
Well, we've had a new guy coming through there, an English guy, Dean Harrison, so he's only 25. Lee Johnson from Ireland's only 25. James Cowton's 23. There's a new generation of guys that's coming through, because your John McGuinness and your Bruce Sanstey's are, you know, in their 40s. Ian Hutchison's injured. Guy Martin might go elsewhere. So we have to look to these 25-year-olds, and the future looks good with them.
Yeah, even if someone, as Bruce Sanstey, is still setting lap records.
Well, Bruce is like Joey Dunlop. You know, Joey Dunlop won the TT when he was 48. Bruce will be 46 at next year's TT, but he's still the fastest TT rider.
Yeah, it is indeed. How do you see the future of road racing and the future of Road Racing Ireland as a magazine?
It sort of goes hand in hand. The future of road racing has always been in the riders' hands, you know, how they treat it. You know, people have said road racing was going to stop, you know, in 1986. You know, it's always a fine balance.
Yeah.
And it's just a question the riders have to learn, the organisers have to make it safe, the spectators have to appreciate the being safe areas, and it all goes hand in hand. But Road Racing Ireland will always be there to cover it, and even if it does stop someday, people want to refresh all the old stories again, so it's like an old history book, it'll never go out of date.
Yes, it is really updated with facts, news, interviews, and also a part regarding history of road racing. Doesn't it?
Well, this is it. You know, as I say, if road racing stops, it will become part of history.
Yeah.
And we're lucky enough that we have all the photographs, all the, you know, that can make it, you know, a historical book.
It's called loyalty.
But we hope we don't see that day for yet.
Yeah. Very good. Thank you very much, Leslie.
Not a problem.
Keep up the good work. Thank you.
Hope you understand.
Yeah, sure.